Oh well. Hey everybody, is anybody there? Let's kick this off. So, while I watched Florian building his games, I was always thinking, can we break it somehow? The good thing is I didn't in particular watch the stream there. I just saw the result. The result was pretty funny. I played it also. But in the end, I was thinking, I'm not sure if it's that protected or secure. Would it be possible to cheat in this game? Let's have a look at the game itself. Here it's called Mad Genius Game. Just let me switch my mic a bit. Much better. Here you can put in your name. Let's make it Marcus. And you see, I earlier played a few times. What can we learn just from the website here? Maybe I should have started it earlier, the network tools. What happens here? What can we see? Nothing. Let's load it again. And we can see it's fetching socket.io, like expected. Let's have a look at the stream stats. Is there even somebody here? If you're there, just write something in the chat, please. So now we have our console up. Test again. And I guess this is what we're interested in. Let's see what's in there. This is the upgrade to a WebSocket connection. Not so interesting. That's okay thing. Okay, this is probably Socket.io magic. Here. I think this is what we are after. Now there's a message for the leaderboard, which is kind of boring, but just we cannot change it or anything. But I guess this message could be quite interesting. Create some more. Can we see it somewhere? Probably fishing a bit in the dark here. This is what I was looking for. We can see the whole exchange of messages. It seemed that there's some kind of probe or whatever, but I'm not so interested in it. I would be interested what this 42 here is even. Maybe it's a constant, I don't know. I mean, we could have a look at the stream, what he built there, but just tried it as a black box. So we have this 42 here, and it's saying respawn 0. This is what I had in here. It seems that somebody's at least watching here. And he's playing the game, that's kind of awesome. Let's see what happens here. I mean, here we just get new questions and some kind of pings. So my idea would be, I think there are multiple ways to break it. I mean, for sure you could use some kind of automated tool, which is just extracting that info from the DOM and calculating a result and just putting it here and pressing enter. I think this would be pretty much working. Another way would be to totally emulate the front end here. Just get rid of the front end at all and just have a look at the WebSocket connection. Sadly, I have not done both, at least the solution with reading the DOM. I think I did something like that 8 years ago. And the other solution, where we get rid of the front end, I didn't do it with WebSockets, to be honest. See, I'm already losing this. Or am I? I don't know. So what options have we here? I think first thing I would look into is how can we let's get rid of this bookmarks. No, it doesn't work. Whatever. So what if that doesn't work? Okay. What how can we inspect WebSocket traffic? Maybe not with Chrome? No, it's not even inspect. What do we want to do? Interact with WebSocket from shell. Seems there are some tools already. This is on GitHub. This is often quite good. Has a lot of stars. So what can we do? Connect to public Echo server. We install with Brew. I'm on Mac, so Homebrew is a package manager and it's really easy to install stuff with it. Let's try it. Item. Oh, popped up on the wrong monitor. So let's see. Just install it. Do we have some kind of URL here? I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't go for WebSocket, but more like Socket.io. What's FileCamp? No, that's just monitoring. I mean, the good thing would be just use it for. Let's download it. Is it free? I don't get a demo. Whatever. Now we also can install it with Prune, it seems. Let's do this. For RB, yeah, it's still downloading. When you have any questions, just feel free to ask here. That's why we are here after all. So we're installing FireCamp, whatever that is. Going back to the URL here. Can we just copy that? I don't know. Copy link address. Looks like a WebSocket to me. Yeah, looks good. So FireCamp installed. Just started. I'm pretty sure this is valid. So something popped up again on the wrong screen. Here we are. What's it about? You can create a project. Yeah, share some love. I don't know. Retime socket.io. Let's take a look. You can connect here. This is what we are after. Config option right side setting icon. Ah, that one. Oh, I'm blind. Here you can add multiple listeners. Maybe we can even finish it here then. I don't know. Whatever. We could also go for polling. This would be quite interesting. Connect. Can we get rid of the session ID maybe? Probably I'm doing something wrong here. I don't know. Prime Wallet with namespace. No, this is not how it ends here. I don't think so. Is this really the URL? I don't know. It looks like it. It's doing a get and then it's connected. I was thinking if you should start just implementing a Node.js client ourselves and giving that a try. I didn't do this for a long time, but we could try at least. Hacker-pop. Hacker-pop. Let's make a npm init. Package name, hacker-pop, version, description. Yeah, make it app.js maybe. Test command, I don't care. Is this okay? Yes. So, how did we call it app.js? Start it with code. See how Socket.io works. Like I said, I did use it during a hackathon probably 6 years ago, but I think it's pretty easy. Is there something like getting started? Oop. Yeah, but this is Express, right? And this is what we are after. So let's use npm. We're gonna install socket.io. So we even need Express for it, it seems. Oh well, let's see. Just use that version here. I'm okay with it. No, but this is the server part actually. Let's see how it goes. This is a client, and for what is it? Is it a JavaScript library? Oh, I misclicked. Looks good. So actually, I guess this kind of code is often used in a frontend. Yeah, maybe we could do a React app here, but whatever. I think this should also work in a backend then. Just socket.io node. Oh, I didn't save it. Right. Yeah, this is something I need to get used again to. Save, yeah, but I think my Express was not needed. Oh, what would be the easiest way actually? Let's think. I mean, what also could work here is just creating an HTML file, right? Let's try that one. So, my frontend HTML. My My idea would be that we now use here the URL we had earlier. This is HTTP. I'm kind of confused now. Maybe we can get away with this one. See how this goes. Socket on. What is socket on doing here? Socket on connect. Maybe not emitted. But let's see how that goes. Is this even possible by just opening the thing in a browser? I don't know. Let's try it. It's not finding that one. Of course, is there some CDN? Let's see if we can find it. Let's just take this one. Probably it must be okay. Probably running into a few. Yeah, but it seemed that it somehow connected. At least I'm getting the pings here now. What happens if I go to the other one and say like 28? So I'm getting the message already here. That's kind of interesting that it works that easy. Is your name really Asmanager iPod? Is this how you wanna get called? Sorry, I didn't watch the chat. How are you doing? Let's continue on this one. We now received the questions already. We could try past them. I'm not sure what this 42 is about. I think this must be the size or something, isn't it? So I would say socket on. No, it's pretty good. It's a bit late and I'm struggling a bit here with the whole JavaScript ecosystem, it seems. But at least making some kind of progress, so I'm quite happy. And this is how you're gonna learn, right? Function data. And here we can console log the data. I'll make it pretty stupid and just say, hey, here, yeah, 42. Because I'm not sure if this is the right thing to do. Let's see how that goes. Let's make it 6. Sadly, we don't get any output here, it seems, right? Oh, maybe I should have read some tutorials about Socket.io. Yeah, I guess it's not really complicated if you use that library for a while. But like I said, I'm a bit struggling here, but I think we will do something. Where's this news coming from? This is getting emitted at the server. So I'm pretty sure the topic here should be 42. I guess that should be right. Because this is at least what we're seeing here. I mean, it would be interesting if there's a method to receive everything in socket.io. Socket on every topic or every event. Let's see if we can figure this out. Respond to all events with one handler. So I think the short answer here is no. You too. Have a good one. Bye. I mean, this must be 42 actually. Socket on. I mean, what is this 42 actually? Maybe we can learn something from the source here. I'm not sure. And the good thing is, it's not even uglified or anything. It's good. Let's see. Mean, it's also a socket on question. Yeah, maybe we can do this also then, huh? Let's do this socket on question, but now I wanna see why we were wrong. Okay, maybe that's the length then, this 42. I don't have any clue. So what I expect now is that we maybe do it like that. That we should be able to get the questions here. Console. So let's say, huh, this must be that. Okay. We got a console output, and now we can interact with the socket. Actually, we can even try to copy the code from the game itself. That's pretty handy since it's already done here. There must be something that's saying, hey, in case. Ah, here, this socket emit response. This is what we're looking for. Now the question is, it must be only this value. Let's see how we get the result here. What we want to do is in question, we log the data now. Let's see what's in there. So that's it. Now we could try to parse it somehow, but maybe there's something easier. I'm not sure. I think there was something like eval. JavaScript calculate formula from string, something like this. I think not using eval. Okay, is there something? String to mat, whatever. Is this even a thing? Just try it in the console here first. Let's say we make this here 9 times 2. I think we should don't forget to log it. Up, 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 up. String to mat is not defined, so what kind of thing is this? Oh, maybe we try just eval. I mean, it's a hacky solution here and you shouldn't use eval all over the place, but I guess here it would be actually okay. I'm getting more and more tabs already. Let's say what happens if we do something like this. Eval. Oh, see, we get a result. So could say more result equals eval. Data was, yeah, it should be this here actually. And then we can do a socket emit response and just do this here. Now I guess we should be, when we refresh this, we should be pretty much winning. The only thing is, I guess this refreshes all the time and I'm not sure who's gonna get the score for this. Since currently we don't have any user, we don't have had a look how this is working right now. So let's refresh this for once. Maybe I move this tab over here a bit, put in an 18. And what happens here? It seems like our front-end code is all the time answering the questions. This is exactly what we wanted. Awesome. Maybe now there's no way to stop it, right? That's not so good. Just for now, get rid of this here. Refresh. And now we need to think about how we get a user. This would be the only thing. Yeah, how do we get a user? Maybe we can also get it from here. Socket emit user joined. Can get rid of this connect, just emit user joined. I am the best, maybe. And let's try it without it. Refresh. And I guess we did it. You can see, I guess it's pretty impossible to win this by typing. At least I guess so. Just have a look at it. I mean, it's totally broken. That guy here is gonna win it. I was pretty focused on the code right now. I think Samuel and Mihai just joined. How are you guys doing? Let's see if they're even there. One concurrent view, or maybe. So actually, I think if you have some questions, just feel free to ask. I mean, I think I already reached what I wanted to do. Because with this pretty quick solution, we just broke the game. I mean, what's nothing about what could have prevented this? I'm actually not too sure. I mean, there a good thing already is that this here should not be that visible. It must be kind of uglified or something, but this is not helping because in the end you always can just have a look at the protocol, what kind of messages are getting exchanged. Also, you could add, I don't know, some kind of checksums in the messages so that you're not able to do this easy construction of messages. But actually, I think right now there's not much you can do. One thing that would be good is a rate limit or just maybe some threshold that you cannot send that many messages. But also, this would hinder fair players. So, right now, I'm also a bit unsure what I would have done or what we could do to prevent this. So now this I'm the best guy is already pretty much winning it. But that's actually okay, I guess. This was a pretty quick stream, it seems. I hope you liked it, and I think about just going offline. At least in a few minutes. Just let me know in case you have any questions. Just use the chat. Have a look at the Discord here. I think there are not so many people already there. So that was it. It was a funny quick session. Thankfully, I didn't need to use a lot of Node or anything. Just built a simple JavaScript client. I think what would have helped there is I guess you can limit URLs which are able to access your backend. Then it would not be able to connect in a browser doing this, but then I would just have to write a Node client, I guess. This is also not helping. I'm really thinking what can be done there. Maybe I come up something over the next hours or so, but let's see. Hope you enjoyed it as much as I did, and I wish you a good night, evening, whatever. Bye bye.